Φίλες και φίλοι, έχουμε τη χαρά και την τιμή να φιλοξενούμε σήμερα τον Έτορε Μεσίνα, έναν από τους κορυφαίους coach στην ιστορία του ευρωπαϊκού μπάσκετ. First of all, coach Μεσίνα, welcome and thank you for your time. It's always an honor and a pleasure chatting with a legendary coach European basketball. So far, it's been the best start for Armani almost for all the years I remember, you know, in the elite competition. And the most important is that this is happening with new players and new voice on the bench.
Probably because of that.
Why?
I think we had we have a good group of people, first of all. And with the players have different skills, but they're all very good people. They work very hard. They have good chemistry. And we have a couple of the, let's say, very important leaders, especially Sergio Rodriguez and Luis Scola, that with their experience and their background can really help everybody else to understand what is necessary to do.
It seems that your presence this season in Milan changed everything, because always Armani had big budget, great city to live, great organization, but not any special urgency for success. Do you feel that you raised that way of thinking in the club?
I think it's more a group work. It's not one person who can change anything. And I agree with you that it's very important to have a sense of urgency that doesn't need to be, let's say, craziness for result. But at the same time, it has to be a sense of accountability, that you take responsibility for how things go on and off the court. And of course, Christos Stavropoulos is a key person to try to instill this kind of mentality. So it's not something that you do by yourself, for sure.
It's been 28 years since the last time that Armani advanced to the Final Four. Five
Don't
years.
Tell me that.
5 years, you know, from the last time you compete for the playoffs.
Yeah.
So, because you know very well that success in EuroLeague means, you know, to be in the Final Four. What is the goal for this season? It's step by step.
Listen, the history of the Final Four in the last probably 15 years tells you that probably always the same 6-7 teams, if I'm not wrong, with the exception 1 year of Partizan and another year of Žalgiris, yes. It's always been the same 6-7 teams. So to break that is right now very, very difficult. And it's not even possible to think about Final Four if you don't start being consistently in the playoff. So our main goal is now, and as for the future, to be in the playoff.
Do you feel that tonight you're facing the less dangerous team of Olympiacos the last decade?
Honestly, I disagree. They are going through a lot of difficulties because the fact that they decided to leave the National League, the fact that Coach Blatt had to leave for the well-known reasons, they had their shares of injuries. So I've seen them playing the last two games in Germany, and I haven't seen a team. I've seen a team who is playing with discipline and with a lot of desire to get back to the right track. And don't forget that this is a team that beat CSKA, the reigning champion, on their home court just 4 weeks ago.
You like the new format of EuroLeague?
I like it very much. I think that to have only 8 teams out of 18 to compete in the playoffs is not rewarding enough. We have a lot of owners and people who invest a lot of money. And I think that we need to give these people a little bit more of hope. I would be, and I've said this, that I would be interested in considering at least the possibility of 12 teams going to the playoff, and maybe have a first round, a shorter first round, if the dates would be available, to just have, you know, more possibility to create the dream.
If we tell you that one of the our favorite and most exciting moments of this season will be your two games against Obradovic, which will be yours?
Listen, it's I understand what is the dynamic for a journalist or for a fan, but it's never coach versus coach.
For a guy like you with 25 titles in your career, many honors, who has worked like more than 30 years in the highest
Too
level
many.
Of the highest level of the world basketball. What is Ettore Messina chasing, you know, this year? Are you giving yourself a special motivation, you know, in order to prove something?
Incredible opportunity to work for Mr. Giorgio Armani, you know, and So far, the thing that has made me very happy is that we average almost 10,000 people per game, and we had already two or three sold-out games. You know, that's very important because to let's say deserve the love and the support of a city like Milano is not easy. And if we can help, if we can make this consistent, I would be very, very happy. Personally, as I said many, many times, I just wanted to have one last opportunity to be a head coach after learning from Coach Popovich and the Spurs. And I had this opportunity, which is honestly a big opportunity, and I took it.
By coming back from the NBA after 5 years, mm-hmm. You introduced a brand new role, you know, in European basketball, which is very applicable in the NBA, the double position of the president of basketball operation and the coach. Mm-hmm. This is something that, do you think that can work, you know, in the European basketball?
What about Zelimir Obradovic in Fenerbahce? He doesn't have the title, but he the main responsibility for the decision, together with the owner, is his. What about Coach Pitino here with Panathinaikos? What about Šarūnas Jasikevičius in Žalgiris? I think it's a matter of more than job titles. It's a matter of relation, of straight relationship between the coach and the owner, and to be lucky to have a person like Christos Stavropoulos that takes away the daily responsibility to touch issues that are not straight related to basketball, you know, and who don't have an ego, and basically they are on the side of the owner and the coach in order for those two people to take the best possible decision for the team.
How big of a college degree or PhD is to work every day and be very close with the great Greg Popovich? I mean, which is the biggest lesson that you learned from him?
That he doesn't want to give lesson to anybody. He just said, with his own behavior, with his charisma, with his knowledge, with his sense of humor, he set a very high standard for everybody who would like to have the same profession.
Do you think that one European coach can coach over there as a head coach,
sure,
or is very difficult?
Sure.
So, because it's a players' league.
Somebody will have the opportunity, no doubt. It will be. It's just a matter of time. Igor Kokoskov had the opportunity. Unfortunately, it didn't work very well for him. There are a lot of assistants right now with European roots, or even let's say actively European, like Coach Sergio Scariolo with the Raptors. I mean, somebody will have the opportunity. It's just a matter, like for a female coach. Sooner or later, it will happen.
We are living, you know, in the era that European players are dominating more and more in the NBA. We arrive at one point that two European or three European guys will be the main guys in the NBA, like Giannis Doncic, the next 4 or 5 years.
Well, I think it might happen. I think in the NBA, people are getting used now to take away the label of American, European, white, Afro-American, whatever. Yes, I think it's a great sign that people are becoming more open, and the stereotype that, for example, European are soft, that was very, very strong 20 years ago, now it's disappeared, you know, so it's a matter of adjustment, and sooner or later, as you say, there might be a franchise that put together 3-4 top Europeans trying to compete for the championship.
One technical question that I always want to ask, especially to Pop.
Please.
But I don't dare.
I give you his phone number.
Why NBA coaches don't foul in the last seconds, you know, after they are winning by 2 or 3?
Well, first of all, it's not true that all of them don't do that. There are coaches like D'Antoni that do that, and others. I think because...
But the majority.
You're right. I think that they started it. I think that they have, you know, all those analysts took percentage and whatever, and they came down to this decision. But honestly, it's not a big deal. Come on.